Thank you. Thank you for the magnanimous introduction from Dr. Tajmal Saudi, sir. It's indeed a pleasure for me to be associated with this particular forum, the Indo-Pacific Academy of Forensic Nursing Sciences, and especially with the theme of that advancement in forensic nursing science and practice. I will share the screen with you. Is it visible to all? Is it visible for all of you, Dr. Ranjit?
Yes, sir, it is visible. You can make in a presentation mode.
Yeah. Of course, as I mentioned already, it is a very, very big honor for me.
So sorry to interrupt you, sir. It is not in the presentation mode. Can you click on the
button? Yeah. Just a minute. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Now is it fine now?
Perfectly fine, sir.
Okay. Sorry for the delay. Okay. Now it is indeed a pleasure for me that I am going to present this particular topic in this platform. Personally, I feel very much honored to be here because mainly the reason is almost 10 years ago, to be more precise, in 2009 itself, when we started this university as a Gujarat Forensic Sciences University, we were in the fledgling stage as an university. That time, the first thought come to our mind because of our then chief minister, the current prime minister, Sri Narendra Modi sir. He was mentioning about the importance of forensic nurses, and he suggested introducing a particular specialty of forensic nursing. So we started with the academic, the preparation of the curriculum with a holistic approach, wherein there should be an entire component of forensic sciences in pertaining to the nursing practice. So in that way, we developed the curriculum. For the initially, we started with a diploma program, that is post basic diploma program, and that nomenclature also was not available that time, and we got approval from the Indian Nursing Council. Then we started with this curriculum from 2014. To be more precise. Then it happened in such a way that there was a slow and steady progress, I should say. And moreover, to be very, very honest, that the particular opportunity that has to be created for the graduates, those people who are getting graduated with the forensic nursing was very much minimal. So that is probably that has taken some sort of what I can say, not that much of an expected momentum was there. But off late, after a gap of 4 to 5 years, once again, we started this particular academic program in our university. In fact, with we are contemplating the post-graduation in the same specialty. Of course, we are thankful to the council, who have been very much supportive to us and very much cooperative, and all sorts of technical support they are providing for that. Through this platform, I am thankful to the Indian Nursing Council. And of course, I had an opportunity, and I should say fortunate to have come across with numerous experts in this area. Gorilla sir, in fact, we used to have a communication with each other over the phone and off late in number of conferences in Bangladesh, Bhuvaneshwar, and other conferences we had met, and we have started developing this particular theme and program. This is the actual preview I can give you. Then when it comes to the actual presentation part, as we all know that we are having a huge human data potential, in the sense being a second most populous country in the world, we have large number not to be taken in a negative way, cases. Those are pertaining to the offenses in general, and more importantly, those are pertaining to the medico-legal practices. So there is no dearth as far as the data is concerned, or no dearth as far as cases are concerned. But the important aspect is that though we have produced a large number of nursing professionals, there are, as an optimistic person, I can mention that we are handful of experts in forensic nurses. So I think slowly we are taking the cues from the world, I should say the Western world, with a mission of forensic nursing. I think it will go a long way to capitalize this particular specialty's importance in general within a short period of time. That is what I am presuming. And as such, it is globally accepted, and everybody accepts the fact that nurses as such are the glorious professionals. Of course, they are always glorified because of their selfless services. So in that way, definitely they are the ones who are most sought after. In any particular scenario, where there is a need for clinical, emotional, psychological support with a compassion. And of course, they are doing the services with compassion and concentrated spirits. As I said already, this is a evolving entity, evolving specialty. This has not been very much, I should say, established as any other forensic fraternities, like medicine or pathology or dentistry, or even dentistry also. So one thing I always used to mention about is, it is always presumed to be associated with the clinical care to the victim, or I should say a patient. That is the sole objective with which Florence Nightingale, I always used to mention about the selfless services of Florence Nightingale, and again with our own Mother Teresa. But having said that, when it comes to the particular entity of people who are suffering because of some uneventualities, so there is a need. There is a compulsion. It is a compulsion that forensic nurses are to be produced because of the gravity of the situation. That is, any particular situation or uneventuality wherein the necessity of not only the clinical care, but also a sort of a psychological, social, psychosocial, medico-legal, legal perspectives, all these things are prompting a particular professional to be essentially required in a particular period of time. That is, in that scenario is repaired, that will be, that sort of demand will be fulfilled only by the forensic nurses. That is what is my perspective. So obviously, this includes all these entities, all these parameters, all these vital virtues, what I always used to mention as psychosocial aspects, clinical care, psychiatric nursing, and of course, investigative also. So in that way, forensic nurses are the ensemble of both, I should not even use the word both, it is a versatility, that is medical, medico-legal, social, psychosocial, psychological, psychiatric. So in one way, I'd be able to say that they are the torch bearers. I am contemplating that forensic nurses from India should be the torch bearers, because as I already mentioned about the vast potential of experts, resources, expert resources in the country will serve the purpose not only for the nation, for the entire globe. how to mention about the detailing of the particular specialty, how it is actually, how it is becoming a versatile or prolific one. Because as I have already mentioned about the opportunities that is very much there, and it is more and more prolific in nature. And why it is? Because of the way the curriculum has been developed. I should say, as I was initially mentioning about the curriculum, which is having a vital components of clinical care to the victims of any uneventuality, especially to the people, to the women folk. So naturally, in the cons, a conservative, predominantly a conservative society of India, they need a particular professional who will be able to provide not only the healing the wounds, the particular injuries, but simultaneously they should be capable of providing some sort of reassurance to them to come to terms with certain conditions like offenses against women or child abuses or elderly abuses, wherein more of a they are suffering from more of a psychological trauma than the tougher physical one. So naturally, in such a scenario, there is a requirement of these forensic nurses to be in place to take care of all the needs, all their needs. So they will be healing them the physical healing of the injuries, that is management of those people, that is clinical management is provided. Along with that, there is a psychological management, in the sense they are suffering due to the trauma. So naturally, they need to have some sort of emotional support that can be provided only with the forensic nurses, because they are already having the expertise of clinical as well as psychiatric and psychological nursing. In addition to that, there is also a particular component, I should say, it is not associated only with the crime against women at all. It should not be, in this platform, I want to emphasize that it should not be considered as only service providers for the affected victims, I mean, affected women. I don't want to confine them as a, caregivers for the woman alone, the woman who are affected with some offenses, that is, they are the victims of some offenses. That should not be so. It has to be more and more broader. Widen the purview of the forensic nurses, not to confine them only with the woman folk, that is, affected women or even children or elderly. It is a very, very wider perspective it is. I should say, if at all we have to get a detailing of that, women-related issues, so of course, we are knowing already, that is, any sort of offenses against men, domestic violences, harassment at workplaces, and of course, trafficking, human trafficking also offenses against children, or children are being trafficked for various reasons. So that causes physical and mental hurt to those people. Here again, it is not only associated with the women, all the affected people, they need a sort of a support, psychosocial or psychological or emotional support is required in addition to the clinical management. So, but having said that, when I was mentioning about the obligations, legal obligations or the medico-legal obligations, I should say, as I was mentioning about the contemporary society or a very, very conservative society of India, they are stigmatized. Obviously, even though we are in the 21st century, there was a stigmatization of those affected women, or in general, any such people. For that matter, I am not singling out the woman alone. even children also. So there is a stigma. It is a social stigma, and those people are stigmatized and victimized. So it is a sort of a social isolation they are in. They are suffering with more of a psychological trauma. So that needs to be addressed. And that addressing can be done, solution or resolving those in complexity will be possible only with the legal obligation. And simultaneously, for the legal obligation, we need to have a medico-legal concept. So this medico-legal support is probably achieved, though we have experts, forensic medicine experts with us, but it will be better taken care of in a given scenario, not to be taken as an offending one. I think everybody will take it in a positive manner. I want to convey that this conservative society needs to have some sort of forensic nurses who will be able to handle the particular situation with a holistic approach. That's what I mean to say. So evidence collection from the particular individual, from the affected individual, can be done with a genuine touch from the forensic nurses. So obviously, of course, we have a vast majority of medical officers and medico-legal experts are available, but as a legal operation that needs to be handled by a person, there is a gender preference also in that case, where nobody can rule out that. So there is a particular gender who has to take care of that. So naturally, I feel there is a requirement of forensic nurses who will be able to have provide the services with the holistic approaches. And this is one particular aspect. Next one is, as I was mentioning previously, it should not be confined only with the sexual offenses alone. There are a number of other things. During the disasters also, they are going to provide valuable services, a noble service they are providing in such a scenario. It was again an unforeseen situation. For that matter, everybody glorifies, in fact, boasts to the service of nurses during the pandemic, how they effectively handled selfless services they did. Nobody can deny that. Of course, this is one part of it. But in general, any other man-made disasters or the natural disasters, there are requirement of this comprehensive victim management, whatever which I have addressed to. So that is again within the ambit of forensic nurses alone. Not only doing the clinical care, reassurance, emotional support, they are part of the medico-legal services also, forensic science services also, in the form of evidence collection, more importantly for victim identification. They are supporting in victim identification, they are supporting in dead body management, they are supporting in the evidence collection, all sorts of things. They are a part of the particular management in general. I should say their contribution is, of course, more than 50%, I should say. In that case, it needs to be understood the importance of forensic nurses are, I should say, they are at high stake. So that needs to be understood, and it has to be propagated in a very, very holistic manner, so that each and every organization, each and every forum, each and every association, professional association, should acknowledge the professional knowledge and expertise of forensic nurses in whatever way possible. So they have the major responsibility of bringing the victims back to the normal. So this is what I am again and again emphasizing, the importance of forensic nurses. So legal obligations could be done or accomplished based on the medico-legal aspects, which is again contributed from the forensic nurses. Not only that, they are providing the social, psychosocial, and other related issues also. Even next, coming to the any other forensic sciences also, offenses against in general, individual or offenses against, more particularly about the women. Naturally, in each and every case, forensic nurses should be there because of the nature of particular offense. So there again, the collection of all those biological matter or anything which is required will be always collected by them in a very, very, very splendid manner. And that will be an exponential component in such a case. Of course, as I mentioned, forensic nurses are the true warriors and the frontliners in the. When it comes to the opportunities, as I mentioned already, that there is a huge potential in our country. Actually, I am actually representing our university and India. So I'll be able to understand the importance or the, what I can say, numbers, the requisite, the need that I'll be able to assess in our country. So our country, that is the main reason why I was mentioning that these Indian forensic nurses will become as torchbearers for the entire world, I should say, with I am saying that because of the huge number of expertise that is available in the country, but not to be taken in other sense. But I do have respect, regard for all the experts across the niche, across the world, let it be Canada, US, South Africa, and European nations, Southeast Asia, everybody. But considering the numbers in the country, these people are capable of taking this profession and the academia to a greater extent, to the greater heights, so that we will be gathering all of our team members and experts along with us, so that it becomes a very unique and unique professional profession, and also a most sought after profession in the given scenario. That is what my point is. So naturally, I should say there are no expertise, there is no depth of expertise in the country. Experts are available. And one more thing is, I am very happy that our subject has been included as a curriculum in the bachelor's degree. So that will take this particular profession in a longer than to reach the greater heights. So hats off to all the nurses who have dedicated their souls and their services for the humanity, especially during the pandemic. Thank you all.